Hey Wildcats, I'm Maven, these are your daily announcements. Good luck to the Cat Band when they perform Saturday at 7:30. If you signed up for the Seal of Biliteracy test in the fall, you should have received a calendar invitation for the November 15th test date. Important details for the testing day are in the invitation. Please accept or decline this invitation and direct any questions to Ms. Bausch.
With the fear of Hurricane Milton being as, if not more destructive than Hurricane Helene, an evacuation order was sent throughout most of Florida, but one man stood strong amongst the chaos. This man, nicknamed Lieutenant Dan, stayed on his boat while the hurricane was raging through the Tampa area. Because he would not evacuate, his story became TikTok famous. He claimed that if the water level rose, so would the boat, and he would be safe. Lieutenant Dan ignored all government officials and sent them away when they told him to evacuate the area, because he claimed that he had nowhere else to go and he was safest on his boat. Popular streamer Aiden Ross promised a kick deal and a new boat if he and his boat survived. But Aiden Ross retracted the offer after backlash because of Lieutenant Dan's criminal past. Lieutenant Dan survived the storm and lived to tell the tale. You can check out his story on multiple TikTok videos, which have racked up millions of views.
Club Photo Day is Friday. Your club sponsor will give you a pass for Club Photo Day. Only passes created by Cats by Yearbook will be accepted. Make sure you bring your pass and school ID with you to Club Photo Day. You should be in the Lopac lobby 5 minutes prior to your photo time to check in. Keep up with your pass. It will be your ticket back to class. These photos are taken for yearbook purposes only, so if you're on FERPA, please do not take a photo with your group. Wednesday is a half day and we will follow the PM schedule.
I'm Malachi and I'm here with
Nephew Booth.
If someone were to make a school threat or a student threat, how would you take action?
Well, we take each one of them as their own circumstance, but we treat it as worst case scenario. We fully investigate. Our job is just to make sure the whole entire school is safe, that y'all are safe, and all you're here to do is learn. It really depends on school threat or student threat.
What do you consider a threat?
Anytime someone says, I'm going to beat your tail, I'm going to punch you, that's a student threat, kind of enticing bite. But school threat would be, I'm going to blow up the school, I'm going to shoot the school. That's, like I said, it's taken very serious and it can happen. We're going to do whatever we can to prevent it and we'll have to fully investigate it.
What are the consequences?
So there's two avenues. There's the school side and there's the law enforcement side. The school side, of course, up to expulsion. It can be. The law enforcement side, it can be charged. You'll have to call your parents in and charge you. I mean, potentially. If we just have to get the facts and circumstances and figure out where it goes from there. It can be quite severe because you're scaring the school, you're scaring students within the school. School has got to be safe.
Thespian Society will have a meeting tomorrow after school in room C104 from 4 to 4:30. Active and applicant members are invited. They will be finalizing plans for Wiley's Fall Festival and giving out Club Picture Day passes. If you signed up to bring items for trunks, please do so at that time. Revamping your resume doesn't have to be an intimidating task. Join the experts for a lunchtime workshop to refine and elevate your professional profile. Bring your lunch to the library. This collaborative session will provide the guidance and support you need to present yourself in the best possible light. Sign up today and take the first step towards showcasing your qualifications with confidence. If you're interested in being a respiratory therapist, head over to the Midlands Tech Airport campus today to learn about their program and what the job entails.
I'm Caroline Locklear. I'm a senior and this is LTC Cosmetology. I like that when we're out of the class, after we complete the two courses, that we'll have our license and ready to go out into the workforce. On Tuesdays and Wednesdays, we have clients, and besides that, we do most of our projects on Thursdays and Fridays and classwork on Monday. We get real life experience in the salon and also our licenses once we complete all 1,500 hours.
Usually, most of the time, we'll come in, go to the classroom, do whatever projects we have to do in there, and then get our kits and come in here and do our projects.
This is our project sheets. We all have our own, and this is all of the stuff we complete. This is all the stuff that we have to complete, and this is our smart notes and our supplies and everything in our vocab. And this is our daily grades, and we can get points taken off. And at the end of each quarter, we get graded on based off everything that we've completed.
My favorite thing about the class is just sitting around in the lab and having girls talk out loud. Benefits of this class is when we graduate, we'll be licensed cosmetologists. We go to State Board, we get our license, and that's what we get out of this. I'm going to miss being around everybody. I'm going to miss my teacher, Miss Brown. It's going to be, you know, hard not having her around on my shoulders and stuff, but I'm excited to, you know, get my license and stuff.
Join counseling for the underclassmen meeting in the LOPAC tomorrow at 6 p.m. The Beat River Bluff t-shirts are being sold during all lunches. You can pay with cash, check, or online. The Beat River Bluff t-shirt is $10 and will be sold until November 8th. There will be an HOSA bake sale on Halloween outside of the Breezeway doors during all blocks. They take cash only.
Congratulations to the senior superlative winners. Most athletic is Lydia Metz and Brandon Cromer. Most artistic, Morgan Hendricks and Nick Elkins. Most likely to brighten your day, Myra Waits and Noah McCleary. Most changed since freshman year, Carson Huff and Sadie Stockwell. Best to bring home, Ava Jordan and Trey Ogletree. Most likely to be late with coffee, Bella Ludi and James Berry. Most likely to be president, Haley Crick and Aaron Robinson. Best friends for girls is Myra Waits and Ava Jordan. Best friend for boys is Carter Jeffries and Tommy Morty. Most likely to come back as a teacher is Shiloh Ralston and Rochelle Patil. And most likely to be a soccer mom or barbecue dad is Sydney Kitts and Logan Hill. Congrats, Wildcats!
Reminder about recycling. No bottles or cups can be put into the recycling that have beverages in them. They also cannot take any sort of food wrapper or paper towel. That's all for today. Have a great day, Wildcats!